Morning and welcome to St. Paul's Monastery. Today is the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is Father Matthews.
Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, one day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, just as you are to worship. As you are to glory your God, come, come, come.
Good morning. We welcome all of you to our chapel here at St. Paul Monastery and those who are joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio. Today we celebrate the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and we come together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you've made me, your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request, because you have asked for this. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." "Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First of all, it's good to have all of you back with us once again in our chapel here on Sunday morning. It's also the first time in 4 weeks that we've actually been televised live from here on our ecumenical channel as well. As you know, we've been in quarantine for 4 weeks, two sets of 14 time days. And the first one was Brother Dismas. Brother Dismas, one of our brothers, went into the hospital for other reasons and had pneumonia. And they discovered he had the virus while he was there. And unfortunately, he passed away about 3 days later. So then when that happened, then all of us went into our first 14 days quarantine. Brother Dismas, for those of you who have been here for a while, used to run our camera up in the choir loft years ago. More recently, he had been in our sacristy during our masses. We will have the funeral mass for him on Wednesday. Unfortunately, all of you will not be able to join us because it'll be a private mass. and then we will bury him out here in our cemetery. But we will have a memorial mass for he and for Brother Kevin Cahill, who was one of our brothers who died earlier this year. And Brother Kevin had worked here and lived here for a number of years and ran our Alba House bookstores back in the 70s and 80s. So we'll have a memorial mass for them, and we'll let you know when that's going to happen. After our 2 weeks, then we all went to get tested, and unfortunately one of our members tested positive, the rest of us tested negative. So he had to end up in isolation, and the rest of us were for quarantine for the next 2 weeks. And then he went back to get tested this Thursday, and he was tested as negative, so that's when we reopened. It doesn't mean that we're not susceptible, so I appreciate all of you wearing your masks and all of you doing your social distancing for all of us here as we continue to even ourselves during the liturgy. But I think these quarantines and what people have dealt with call us to think how we do our spiritual journey. We've had to do different ways. Perhaps we did online or virtual attending of Mass. Maybe we did prayer a little bit more. With me not going out and taking people to doctor's appointments, then I was here in the office, and my day didn't change too much because I do everything in-house as it is. And so I was able to do, and I discovered I had more time to do some reading. I had more time for prayer in our chapels, and I had more time to even go online and look at some of the online teachings and videos that are out there that are able to deepen our spirituality. Because our scripture today, especially the gospel, asks us to reflect upon how we welcome the kingdom of God into our life. And the kingdom of God is always with us, always around us. But at times we may not be aware that the Lord is with us. Maybe we're not aware of the signs of the kingdom. And in today's scripture, they give us three ways on which we can discover how the kingdom of God comes into our life. The first is sort of a suddenness. At times it may happen. The more equivalent would be someone like St. Paul, who had this great conversion experience in the midst of doing the thing. And this is seen in the man who is out there farming his field, and he's just doing what he normally does to prepare for the harvest when he discovers this big treasure that's out there in the middle of his field. So then he goes and stops everything and puts all his money together to now buy this field in which he was working, because it was that important to him. So we may encounter the Lord's kingdom, the Lord's presence, in suddenness, things that we're not expecting. All of a sudden, something applies to us. So maybe in our prayer, maybe in our devotions over these last several months, maybe there's been an incident that has happened in our lives where there's been an illness, a sickness, or a death, or something that has come about and brought a change that makes us think about our relationship with the Lord. And so this suddenness enables us to know that the Lord is here, and we want to grab onto that treasure of his presence in our own life. The other aspect is we may be searching, like the merchant who's going around trying to find the greatest pearl that he can find, and once he finds it, he sells everything out to hold on to that pearl. So it's the same way. We are searching. We're looking for the presence of the Lord. So maybe we are reading a little bit more. Maybe we are praying a little bit more. Maybe we are looking at the signs of where the Lord speaks to us and our neighbors and friends and how things are going on around us. Maybe we see the signs of the times in the world that's challenging us to pray for one another, to pray for our country, pray for the things that are going on. And this way we know that we're bringing the Lord into our daily lives and bringing the Lord into how we see him every day. And finally, we have the image of the net being cast out and all people being drawn together. And we might say this is the sign of the church, that we are all part of the church. The church welcomes all of us, those who are of us who are sinners, those of us who are not sinners, those of us who at times are very enthusiastic about the Lord and other times we're kind of lukewarm in our spirituality. But in this way, we want to welcome the Lord into our life. And then that means we not only have a relationship with God, but that means we have a relationship with one another. And so there's that opportunity to say, okay, where can we reach out and help for one another? Our Knights of Columbus, the theme for this year is leave no neighbor behind. Look after our neighbors, not only our brother knights, but look after all those who are concerned. So maybe we've become more concerned about the people around us. We are very blessed of your concern for all of us, because we have many of you who have brought food for us. You have brought your prayers to us. You have offered to help us out in many ways. One person brought me both disinfectant and a bottle of bourbon, and I said I wasn't sure which one I was more enthusiastic to have, and she just said, make sure I don't mix it up when I'm drinking. And I said, okay, so I'll do that. So we're appreciative of those of you who have cared of us as your neighbors, and again, we're glad to have all of you back here with us. So let us all open ourselves up to the presence of the Lord, sharing him with one another as best we can, and bring the kingdom of God into our world and into our lives today. Let us stand together and share our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We call to mind our needs, assured that God knows and cares for us in every single detail of our lives.
For the church, that we who have died with Christ in baptism may recognize our dignity in being children of God and sisters and brothers to one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, that God will strengthen and sustain him and help him to respond to all who request his assistance during these times of famine, disease, and disaster, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill with the virus and those who care for them, that God will send healing to the sick, strengthen the wisdom to those who care for them, and inspiration to those researchers researching treatments and vaccines, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the homebound and the sick, that God will protect them, renew their spirits, and give them strength, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the benefactors and cooperators of the Society of St. Paul, that the Divine Master may bless their generosity as they proclaim the gospel through the media, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we pray this Mass, let us remember Dominique Leon. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also want to remember Brother John Joachim on this, his feast. Today is the feast day of Saints Joachim and Anne. That the Lord will continue to inspire his life and ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous and merciful God, may your great care and compassion for your people inspire us to be generous with our care and compassion for all those in need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Are they the poor?
Sorrow, they shall be consoled.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, all our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Paul, Saints Joachim and Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We can offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Just a reminder, the celebrant and the communicants will be on each of the door, and we ask that you come down the center aisle and then go to the side doors to receive the host.
Mystery of faith, calling us to venture to the deep. Though our senses fail, your graces still prevail, and I become the lover we receive. Bread shall live and never die. Bread of life, bread of life. Your true presence in this holy sacrifice, bread of life. Unworthy though we are, you feed the hungry heart. Bread come down from heaven above, and like a grain of wheat, we fall down at your feet, dying here with you, oh, let us rise. Bread of life, bread of life, those who eat this bread shall live and never die. Your true presence. again with love that cannot end. For what God joins, no one can divide. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live and never die. Bread of life, bread of life. Your true presence in this holy sacrifice, bread of life, bread of life.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Again, we thank all of you for being with us here at our chapel at St. Paul Monastery. Those who are joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio, I thank our musicians and our readers, and we hope that you have a very blessed day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks.